for my second book is called When You Die. So you can find it through the publisher as the press, but on my website, drehill.com/books section. Has a link to if you want to see the access to the purchase that way. You know, print and in digital. I'm going to try to do it. I know you're giving me a name, but you can't even give me a name. I was just going to get first. My legs pulled out the last people at this point. My form found itself as the moon into the darkness, the physical environment of the darkness. I was a harbinger that came pounded into pains and emptiness, a void, taking all and leaving nothing. I was teased so much then. I found myself flat against the wall, gliding across the floor. Moving with the constituents and things. I was the final wall that took the first things. I was the need of the mind until the mind decided that the eradication of all things fled. All the things in balance in the dark was worth violent extermination of the mind. I was the mind. But my mother called me the midnight queen. She called me this because I knew this coming. I saw the dawn, but found freedom in the night. I was born with life is dark, but it was true with all that. I listened to the wheels and slept in the shade. Like the colors of the wind, my eyes were to the painted, dips in the ink of the sky and plastered with the shimmer of the moon. In the night, my blackened skin and the pink in the moonlight. I encompassed everything and yet nothing still. I speak for myself. And long lost nations, I whisper utterances for siblings I do not know, and pains that did not hurt me. I am the monolith of the master, but also as polymath of the I am constant to the children of the moon, burning in the phases, exposed to the sun in different stages. I am the midnight world. I am black and blue, past and present, an eternal echo and an ever present.